We have some medical coverage for you this morning, courtesy of Dr. Laura Waters right here. Good morning to you.
Good morning.
And we are talking about something that anyone who's up at this hour wants more of. It's sleep.
Yes.
But we're going to talk about sleep regarding kids. All right. Now, the one thing I always hear about kids, they need routine all the time. That also accounts for amount of sleep they get each night. Isn't that right?
Absolutely. So one of the biggest things that I think parents fail at is not creating a good sleep routine. So The very first thing that they need to do is to create some of those things that set kids up for good sleep. So about an hour before bedtime actually starts is when they should start to do some of these routine things, like take a bath, brush their teeth, read books, those sorts of things, to kind of get kids settled and ready for sleep so that it preps them. Because the more routine that you create around that, your brain actually recognizes that as kind of those go-to things that you do before sleep, and so it will actually help to start doing some of those things.
Even if those kids are, you know, do the fighting with the parents to stay up later, right? You got to stick to it. Isn't
yes,
that right?
You do. Mm-hmm. And routine obviously is hard to create. You know, it takes a long time to do that. And a lot of kids, you know, there's a lot of things going on. This year's obviously a little bit different with routines and things. And, you know, having sports activities and stuff, it seems like there's a little bit less of that right now. So now is a good time to try and create some of those things, especially right before daylight savings times happen as well. That's a good time to kind of start getting some of these habits in place.
That's a very good point that you brought up, though, about, you know, it's going to take a while to establish this, but once you do, you have to stick to it. Now, the amount of sleep for kids depends on the age, right?
Yeah, so younger kids need more sleep, and we're, you know, infants need lots of sleep, but starting kind of in that toddler age, they need anywhere from 11 to 13 hours a night, you know, and that's including naps and things during the day as well. But then as they get older, they still need a good 9 to 10 hours of sleep at night. Teenagers need a lot more, but teens are also set up to kind of go to sleep a little bit later, around 10 or 11 o'clock at night. And so if they're starting to go to school at 6 and 7 o'clock in the morning, then they're never going to get those hours in. So you definitely need to make sure that you're shutting the phones off and the electronics off at least an hour before bedtime so that you can set up kids for success.
That's another factor, though. You got to make sure to shut them off. You can't have people playing on the phone, especially in the dark, right? That impacts your sleep.
So the blue light that's emitted from electronics, from like phones and tablets and different things, and the TV, it's a shorter wavelength, and so it actually decreases your melatonin production. And so you're hurting your own ability to fall asleep better. So while a lot of people will say that it actually helps them, it may kind of distract you, but in the long term, it's going to make your sleep harder. So shutting things off an hour before bedtime is the recommendation.
It's always important to do. So that's some of the benefits, right, to this. Any side effects as to what people might deal with that?
So if kids aren't getting enough sleep, a lot of times you get a lot of behavior issues. They're grumpy. I mean, hello, we as adults are grumpy if we don't get enough sleep. But they're grumpier. They do more poorly in school. They have a harder time focusing and learning. And there are oftentimes kids that may have ADHD-type symptoms that are actually sleep disorders and not ADHD. So it's something that, you know, we definitely need to make sure that is a priority for kids.
All right, and that's something that you got to make sure that habit sticks, especially during the school year, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
Over the summer, you maybe change up the timing of these bedtime and stuff, but you got to stick to this routine the whole time, right?
Yeah, and the more that you stick to the routine, the better kids are going to do. So sticking within, you know, even on weekends, don't letting them get too crazy with staying up too late, because if you stay within about an hour of your normal routine, kids do better overall.
Great. All right, Dr. Laura Waters, thank you so much for coming in this morning.
And good luck getting those kids to sleep.
Yes, good luck, everyone. Stay with us, though. Daybreak in 10 is up when we come back.